Okay. Thank you very much for your participation, for your attendance, and thank you to the people that is following the this workshop through streaming from other sides of the world. And in this moment, we are going to present the first results about the project that we are participating now. Thank you very much. So after the presentation that Marc Duque did about all the framework that we have in Europe with the new Erasmus All program, the main goal of this workshop is try to identify which is the problems that we will have in mobility processes and try to find the best opportunities to solve this kind of problems through open education in general with open educational resources. So in that case, we are going to present a study that we are participating, my colleague Sophie Tousset from University of Lyon and myself, Edmundo Tovar from this university. We began with this process, try to identify which kind of scenarios could be successful applying open educational resources, doing a general survey with the best practices, in the worldwide. So we got contact with the leaders of the best practices 1 year ago. That's just before all the revolution about MOOCs, etc. So, but that was our starting point. So, if as you can see in the picture in the diagram, when we ask for the best practices about whose main goal was facilitating virtual or physical mobility, we have a low percent of practices, around 16%, but if you analyze the rest of practices, the rest of goals, for instance, improving the learning experiences of the students, encourage the use of OER in their institution, facilitating the creating of OER, all these practices with all these goals could be profit in order to apply in mobility processes. For instance, if you think the developing of new partnership, collaboration, this is a kind of practice using OER that could be applied to improve and to break barriers of mobility processes. Mobility is a priority line inside the European programs. So we check that the full potential of OER and applied to the mobility field is not reached. So the approach that we have taken in order to know how to use this kind of OER was through the designs of scenarios that universities can analyze in order to find this kind of opportunities and how to break these barriers. This, as I said before, this has been an important topic in the European program. So, for instance, I am going to make a brief reference to the OER test. This is another lifelong learning program project that identify as result as outcomes of this kind of the outcomes of this project, identify a specific scenario that obviously could be interesting, the use of OER. So this is graphically explained. U1 is the university that is trying to recognize credits basis on OER learning in other institutions. U2 is the institutions that the students can acquire this kind of outcomes, and later the institutions, the U1, recognize the learning process that the student has acquired in the host university. Okay, this is a brief example of a scenario that was identified in another project, but we want to go beyond because we trust that there are many opportunities now beyond this kind of this typical scenario using OER in Erasmus process. From here, we have worked in trying to identify scenarios, and now Sophie will explain how we organize this, all these ones.
Thank you, Edmundo. So as Edmundo told us, the full potential of open education versus mobility is not reached. And the goal of this project is to see how and to see and to show how open courseware can enhance student mobility. Our three targets, as you can see, are institution, teacher, and students. And the outcomes we are working on are handbooks. For the institution, we want to produce handbooks, but for teachers and students, according to the new affinity of the new generation with the visual, we imagine new outcomes like video clips and also cartoons. Already two clips have been done, and tomorrow you will have the scoop of the finished two video clips by Carl Leuven. So how we proceed to find the scenarios, the methodology was in the first phase was to collect all the possibilities of scenarios we can imagine to help. So at first we make surveys and interviews of international services, students or teachers. And we also organize in the project two workshops at the Cambridge Conference Global for Open Courseware in 2012 and also at Online Educa Berlin in 2012. And in a second phase, we started from a SWOT analysis of Erasmus mobility versus open courseware to select the most relevant scenarios. Because in the first phase, we had approached 20 scenarios, and it was too many. And so if we look at the SWOT analysis, we can identify current weakness and threats to student mobility, such as language issues, cultural differences and opacity of university study programs. For each of these problems, we will show how open courseware can help to solve the problem. Yes. In a third phase, to make those 10 scenarios more helpful and easy to use, we map them on a typical cycle of an Erasmus exchange. All start with the idea in the mind of the students to study abroad. And the first scenarios, for example, will be to choose the best university. And so we can imagine that the universities can create some teaser courses in order to attract students. Then I will now talk about all the 10 scenarios. Edmundo will present some of them. But the idea is to help in each step of the student exchange how open courseware can help. For example, before going, you need some more knowledge. When we will be in the university, you will have to integrate. And we also think after the exchange to make more effective the exchange, and also an alternative as virtual mobility or some bridge between companies and universities. So we will present the outcomes with these maps, and we made one from students, one from teachers, with the same scenarios, and one for institutions with just some differences.
Okay. More in detail about the scenarios that we have identified. The first one could be considered as the teacher courses. This is the first use of open courseware in many international institutions, higher education institutions. That time, that case applied to the mobility case. We can think about the students. This is a tool in order to the students how to select subject in their learning agreement. The student has can acquire background knowledge, and this is the way that the institution can promote the subjects that and the offer and the educational offer that that institution has. No? Associated to these scenarios could be the possibility to build or to develop communities, users' communities. That is the way that native students can help other students virtually in order to create this community and to establish links between them. Another problem that we have identified is the emotional barriers that the students can have. Before to take the decision about to stay in another institution for a period of time. So this is the way the use of OCUW can be used in order to break this kind of emotional barriers and to take this final decision. And this is the possibility to compare universities evaluating the materials, the open educational materials that different institutions has, and to take the more appropriate decision for students. Another obvious use of open courseware scenario is the topic about the language. OCW helps acquiring communication skills in a specific language depending of the destiny of the students. So this scenario can be applied before or the mobility or along or during their staying. The main advantage is that helps students to meet the admissions requirements for the chosen university, facilitates academic and cultural integration in the chosen university, etc. The third one is the bridging. OCW requires for admission to a program that requires mobility. So the advantage of the use of OCW can be that the professor ensures the homogeneity of knowledge among students in the program. At the same time, meet the admission requirements that this program can have. The students acquire essential knowledge prior to mobility. About the cultural and practical information, this is another kind of scenario. OCW facilitates cultural integration and the new way of life. Okay, this is the general definition of kind of scenarios, but I hope that you will understand better the meaning of this, of the description that is behind of this definition through examples that I am going to show you later. This is the obvious scenario that I made reference before in that is only for transparency, comparison, credit transfer. the word that is behind of this scenario is that institutions have to be to reach an agreement about how to make the assessment of the credits of the learning process for each student. Another scenario that we identified in that case was at Berlin in the online EDUCA through the contribution of a participant in the workshop that we organized was the link with the market, with the labor market, with the competencies recognized, more appreciated by the professional world. OCW in the case of students that are staging in another institutions, this is the way to link or to maintain bond to their home university through OpenCourseWare from the original institutions with the community of users that that has been created around this kind of courses, etc. Okay, this is a list of the kind of scenarios that we have identified. By trying to explain you with more detail some of them, I will show you some examples that we have identified thanks to the participation of staff of international offices of different universities. That case, for instance, this is a typical problem that a person in charge of the international office in my university explained me. How Mario, in that case, is the fictitious name, is the ECTS coordinator at Computer Science College in my university, in the UPM, Spain, and he's in charge of the evaluation of the courses, content, his students could take a host institution in order to approve and to include them in the learning agreement, which is the problem that a lot of times this is not possible to know in advance the courses, content, his students want to take at host institutions. Sometimes because this information is not available on the website, or sometimes because the information is not updated. If information is not available, it may happen that at best the learning agreement needs to be changed later, and at worst the course will not be validated at home university. Mario finds out this is a successful description of a scenario thanks to OCW. Mario finds out that some universities have their materials open, what helps him to know precisely the accuracy of the contents, the objective assessment, the credit, etc. So, as a consequence, using this kind of OCW, this information allows the coordinator to sign the student's learning agreement with total confidence and guarantee. Moreover, Mario, as a consequence of this one, Mario starts collaboration with other teachers involved in the same topic he's working in. Okay, this is a real case that could be associated to the general scenarios that we had identified as transparency, comparison, credit transfer, etc. There are more examples for each. Okay, this is another kind of representation, more briefly, more about this scenario without OCW. The coordinator, the ACT coordinator of my university, is not able to accept this particular learning agreement, can't validate their subjects. Another year with the same situation, applying OCW in the ideal scenarios is perfect. I have all the information. I know how to make the assessment. The teachers of the host institution can make the assessment of the learning outcomes. Thanks to all this kind of information, congratulations. He was able to complete the learning agreement. Okay, we have another other examples about how to explain the specific scenarios that we have identified. This is the case of Oscar that studied in Germany. He found once that UP in Spain offers OCW courses in several areas of interest, and he decides to follow one of these courses as self-learning. More later, Oscar is thinking, once the experience has passed, is thinking about the possibility to spend a study period abroad. As a consequence, as a result of the experience that he had before with learning through an OCW course of our university, he's thinking now to apply to Universidad Politécnica de Madrid as Erasmus student. He has been informed by his home university that there is an agreement between both universities, and he decides to apply for the chain for next semester. So at the end of this case, at the end of the semester, Oscar has successfully accomplished a UPM course, an OCW course in Germany. And when we come back home, we will get his courses validated, both the University of Spain and the OCW ones. This is the graphical representation of this kind of scenario. Another example can be about bridging. Elena studies computer science in my university. She's interested in studying a very specific course at another German university. But to register the course, it's mandatory to have deep knowledge in a specific area, and at least she has got a minimum number of credits in the topic. The case is that if we had OCW in the host institution, she finds out that TUEM offers OCW courses in the field she needs to improve, she does the courses, and finally, Elena sends her application to the German university, including the results of the OCW of open course. She's eager to get the admission, although she's a bit nervous. She gets the letter of admission from TUEM to take the specific course she wants to dip in. Finally, in Germany, Elena doesn't have an understanding problem to proper follow the course because her knowledge about the topic is really high, and that is allows her to get a high mark in the course. Okay, we have some examples. The question now is that in our objectives, after the identification and description of scenarios, at the end of this project, we will want to make general recommendations about the institutions, how to apply, which factor they have to know in order to try to implement successful scenarios as we have described. So I will put a brief examples of the guidelines or the kind of specification to each scenario that we have described according to an example of an scenario about language. Language learning. No? In that case, and students of computer science in my university want to move to Italy in order to make another studies. So in that case, which will be the specification requirements for OCW in order to help him to these students to break the barriers of the language before his admission in the Italian university. So we have identified some of this kind of specification. For instance, about didactics, learning style, modular designs, which kind of specification do we need to consider? If the student is of computer science, we will, besides to create a generic Italian course, we have to adapt it to the kind of studies that he wanted to do. So the idea or the recommendation would be to create some model of courses according to the user profile. In that case, is computer science student. So we will have to add in our course a specific vocabulary about computer science. The added value of OSOW in that case is that we are creating virtual communities, and we could promote the production of videos in Italian by joining native or foreign students. Juan makes, the Spanish student, makes a video in Italian about an assignment, but has the support, the collaboration of other native students. About linguistic aspects, okay, we will have to consider the volume rate of students from other countries. If majority of students that comes from my university are from Spain, we will have to adapt our Italian course with explanation maybe in Spanish courses, or with some modules that try to adapt to the origin of the students that come from. Cultural aspect, we can use if the final destiny is Italy, we can use to learn Italian language, texts about the Roman history, for instance. But it can consider two quality assurance of OSOW, because independently of the origin of the of our students, from if we want to learn Italy and we have students from Spain or from German, the final results for all the students has to be the same, because they are because we are applying the same quality assurance. About the production model, we can identify some examples how to make this collaboration model to produce materials, the formation of online communities, and in that case, in that scenario, we have identified several actors involved in these scenarios, as a linguist to create the Italian Spanish course, professor that incorporates the specific technical vocabulary of computer science, the students, native students. Recommendations about the transnational employability, trying to incorporate the opinion of the companies that could be participate in the in practice of the studies program of that institution. Okay. Recommendations and guidelines in general to other topics. The question is that we have identified a lot of scenarios, that the idea is in your institution, which are the scenarios that do you consider feasible or more important, which is the priority that you think that could be applied to the list of scenarios that we have identified. This is the current state of our work. I would like to thank you for your attendance, and if you want to ask you any question, you can do it now. Thanks.